That's right, I murdered him for you!
I'm Jessica Mason, and I'm an emergency medicine resident physician in my second year.
Whoa, Stephanie.
Oh, Dr. Mason, sorry, I didn't see you there.
So I'm working an overnight shift, and it's about 2 a.m.
I'm auditioning for this play. I need to get my lines down.
I decide I'll let her in on my secret that I used to be a ventriloquist before going into medicine.
For real?
For real. And I started doing nightclub shows and comedy clubs. Just had a blast with it.
Do you still do it?
I hung up my dummy a long time ago so I could operate on real patients. Why?
Because the weirdest case just came in. There's a couple in 3R. I don't know what's wrong with the guy, but they've got dummies with them.
Sounds like my kind of people. I'll go check them out.
But you gotta let me tag along. I gotta see your secret talent in action.
No, I didn't say I was gonna be throwing my voice. I'm a healthcare professional these days. I am sympathetic to those in the ventriloquism community, but still, I walk into the room and I cannot believe my eyes. Hi, I'm Dr. Mason. The patient and his significant other have ventriloquist dummies.
What brings you to the ER tonight?
To add to the awkwardness, there is something going on between this couple.
Go ahead then. Why don't you tell the nice lady what's wrong?
This is all your fault, Lisa.
Her fault? You can do your little ventriloquist lap dance for all I care.
OMG. Look, if someone human doesn't speak up soon, I've got plenty of other patients to attend to.
Okay. It's his penis. He's in a lot of pain.
I need to know when the pain started.
Are you satisfied?
And it looked like this couple was not gonna be making my job easy. Sometimes there's bigger social problems that you realize that you've stepped into when you walk into the room.
Can we move this along? This is a bit more than uncomfortable. Oh, so now you're speaking for yourself.
The patient, he seems like he's in a lot of pain.
When did the pain begin?
Yeah, Danny. Why don't you tell the nice lady when and how this started happening?
Earlier this evening while we were watching TV.
Sometimes I wonder which one's the dummy.
With any sort of penis complaint, the more common things would be sexually transmitted infections or skin lesions, maybe a testicular torsion, or sometimes an erection that won't go down.
Get stuffed, Beth!
I already am!
If the dummies could please refrain from commenting, please speak for yourselves.
Sorry, my Beth does have a bit of a nasty streak.
Okay, Ben, let's get back to your situation. How long have you been in pain?
Since yesterday evening, but it's gotten a lot worse tonight.
Let's take a look.
Well, at least someone cares about what's going on down there.
So when I examine the patient, the glands of his penis, which is the tip, is very swollen, and the foreskin is retracted behind the glands, and it looks like it's stuck in that position. I couldn't help but wonder how it happened.
Ever since Lisa brought that new sock puppet into the family, she hasn't given Ben the time of day.
Oh, come on. This was your idea. You couldn't resist those puppet eyes.
Can we have some quiet, please?
I just double-checked that he has not been circumcised, and he tells me no, and that he's had no prior surgeries or injuries to his penis.
We call this condition paraphimosis. Your foreskin is cutting off the blood flow to the penis. There's no damage now, but as time continues, the chance increases of ischemia setting in.
Ischemia?
Lack of oxygenated blood flow to the tissue.
It's an uncommon condition, but having foreskin is the only prerequisite.
There's no reason at this point we shouldn't be able to keep the penis intact, or mostly.
Mostly? No!
If it goes untreated, the patient could lose the tip of his penis, or more of his penis.
It's too early to panic. We have a lot of non-invasive options.
It basically has like a tourniquet effect on the penis and it occludes the blood flow.
But I must warn you, if these don't solve the problem, we may have to resort to a surgical intervention.
Which would be an incision to release that tight band of tissue. And that commits the patient to needing a circumcision.
Please tell me there's another way.
Before we resort to surgical interventions, there's some less invasive options we can try.
So I want to start with the least invasive technique that's possible.
You take a basin of sugar and you put the penis in the sugar. And the idea is to try to osmotically draw the fluid out from the tissue and into the sugar.
Oh, can I get some coffee to go with all that sugar?
This may sound odd, but the sugar can actually help draw fluid out of swollen tissue. And if we get the swelling down, we may be able to slip the foreskin back in place.
So, you want him to put his stuff in a bowl of sugar? That's the best you can come up with?
Isn't that how he got in the situation in the first place?
Beth, enough.
Please, this is humiliating enough.
I don't really know what could have happened that has made her so mad at him.
Sorry, then. Lisa hates seeing you in pain, even though you kinda deserve it.
I don't know for sure why these two couldn't communicate directly, but once I get him situated in the sugar, I decide I'm gonna step out, give them some time to try to resolve things, check on my other patients, and then I'll go check back in on them in a little bit. Let's see how things are shaping up.
I'm afraid the sugar hasn't reduced the swelling.
Does this mean he's headed for surgery? Don't even talk like that.
We're not there quite yet. I'm going to have to try to reduce the swelling manually.
And the couple's jaw drops.
You mean with their hands?
The situation definitely isn't getting any better, and time is tissue.
Pressure will help shift the fluid from the tissue back into the blood vessels and reduce the swelling. The patient could lose part of his penis, which was obviously horrifying for him. He was also quite averse to a surgical intervention, but at this point I couldn't rule anything out. Ben, I'm going to have to hold firm pressure on the tip of your penis for several minutes.
Longer than is comfortable for you or your patient.
Hey, if you're trying to reduce a swollen penis, you're going at that the wrong way, Toots.
Not the way I'm gonna do it, Toots. Stephanie, can you get me some more topical anesthetic and another dose of morphine?
If all you're gonna be doing is grabbing his junk, maybe Lisa ought to do that.
This is strictly a medical procedure, and I'm a trained doctor.
Yeah, dummy. It's science, sir.
Okay, that's enough. Hand over the dummies. Now, this is an ER, not a puppet show.
I can't sit here and get this done while all this bickering is going on between the four of them. So I take their dummies away.
It's about time. I don't know how you put up with these little monsters as long as you did.
Sometimes I think there's more drama in the ER than on stage. Now, brace yourself. This is probably gonna hurt.
I ask him what happened and why did you wait so long before coming in?
Well, it's a funny story, I guess.
I'm sorry, funny? I'm glad you're getting a laugh out of this because it's tearing us apart.
Lisa, don't hit me funny like haha, come back!
What else is going to stop me from treating this patient? My patient wants to go after her, but I actually can't let him go.
Whoa, hold your horses.
So he has to stay until the end of the procedure.
Because he needed constant manual pressure to reduce the swelling of his penis.
I'll try to go find her when the procedure's over.
Okay.
He's really appreciative of this. And then I start to ask him, you know, what happened between you guys?
Ever since Lisa got the new dummy, they've been spending all their time together.
So my patient tells me he feels very neglected.
I couldn't take it anymore, so I tried to make Lisa jealous. So I went to a strip club. Lisa thinks they're the worst.
At the strip club, he got a lap dance. And it was during the lap dance that he first noticed this pain.
And I thought it would go back to normal on its own, but it didn't.
There actually are other documented cases of getting a paraphimosis from erotic dancing.
And when Lisa wanted to make love and I had to tell her no, well, that didn't go over well. And now she just refuses to talk to me except through a dummy.
I say drop the dummies and talk to each other face to face.
So after about 5 minutes of pressure, I decide to check and see where we're at.
Well, I think this worked. The swelling has been reduced. I don't think you're gonna require surgery.
I'm able to pull the foreskin back down over the tip of the glands and reduce the paraphimosis.